But there's another reason, which is I think that globalization is leading not to the creation of enormous blocks of political power, but to the opposite. It is disintegrating old nation states into smaller and smaller units. Because new members of the United Nations are coming all the time. So it's a paradox, if you like, that globalization produces homogeneity culturally, but it produces disparity and division and diversity at the political level. So I welcome this process. I hope that the future belongs not to gigantic nationalists, to compound states like China and Russia, but to small countries, like your country and my country. And I think that there is great hope that the future is ours, not theirs. If you think about, well, Joseph Conrad, the novelist, in 1914, he found himself in his native country, Poland. And the First World War was breaking out as he arrived. And he sat in a hotel with his friends, and they said to each other, "This is the end. From now on, there is no hope for Polish independence, for the independence of small countries, because huge military blocks are going to form and vast empires will dominate the world as this war goes on." And, of course, he was absolutely wrong, because what happened was not just Polish independence, but, as you know, the explosion of, let's see, well, the Habsburg Empire, the German Empire, the Ottoman Empire, and the Russian Empire, and the creation of huge crowd of much smaller nation states. The Scottish nationalism is at one end of a spectrum which defines nationalisms in the plural, which can be very different. A Scottish friend of mine said, nationalism is like one of those ancient statues of the god Janus, who stood over a gateway to the future. And Janus had two faces, one facing backwards, the other forwards. And the backward face of nationalism is looking into the past and saying, "We had a golden age once, and we were more sophisticated than anybody, but we were the victims of neighbors and outsiders and foreigners. And it is an exclusive, usually ethnic-based kind of nationalism, laying emphasis on language, for example." At the other end of the extreme is a kind of nationalism which just says, "We want to join the world. We want to modernize. Only by becoming independent can our country join the world and open ourselves to all that is happening, all the latest currents of emancipation, liberalism, education, technical progress, and of course trade." Scottish nationalism is rather at that end, the modernizing, forward-looking face of James. In 1968, during the Soviet invasion, the Warsaw Pact invasion. And I remember a Russian soldier trying to talk to a crowd of angry Czech people who were around his tank, and he was in the tank. And what he said, "Listen, you are a little nation with little problems. We are a big nation with big problems. That is why you will never understand why we are here." Ha 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 ha.